Greetings and good morning from Olympia, Washington. On my way over here this morning, the trees are all in bloom, the daffodils are up, and the birds are singing, the sun is shining, and you know what? I'm so anxious to get home, I can hardly stand it. I've only been back to Eastern Washington once since session started, and I need a real dose of sunshine, although I understand we're not getting much sunshine in Eastern Washington either. My toes are actually kind of growing together. We've had so much rain over here this year. So the big news right now is the budget, and I'm going to get to that in a minute. So what I really hope we can do this year is get out on time. We've been here since the second week in January. We have 17 days left in the regular session. We're getting seriously close to not having enough time to logistically get the budgets done, which means we'll have to go into overtime. And if we do that, that's about $30,000 a day of your taxpayer dollars, and there's absolutely no reason to be in that position. 17 days left in the regular session. So I'm hopeful that we're going to work weekends, we're going to work long nights, get our work done and get out of here. So the big news on campus this week, and it all started yesterday, is the protesters, the union protesters are down here, and they're protesting tax preferences, or what they call tax loopholes. And let me tell you about some of those tax loopholes that they don't like. Food tax, you want to be taxed on your food? How about nonprofits, churches? I mean, it goes on and on and on. There are about $6 billion worth of tax preferences down here. All of those preferences have been voted through the legislature for one reason or another, usually to make us competitive with other states. So if we take those advantages away, we're no longer competitive with other states and we could lose those industries. So we had protests yesterday. People slept over in the Capitol building. It was locked down last night at 7 p.m. and they didn't let them out until sometime this morning, seven or eight o'clock this morning. So we had people sleeping on the floors in sleeping bags, and we anticipate they're going to happen again tonight. And then on Friday, we're anticipating somewhere around 4,000 or 5,000 protesters to be down here talking about these tax preferences that, again, the legislature has voted on for one reason or another over the years. So the House Democrats, who are in control, finally came out with the budget this week, and quite frankly, it's much better than any of us anticipated. It actually closes the doors on some of the things that we need to do down here, but what it really doesn't do, it does balance the budget, but it does not help us moving forward. They did not address the policies that are causing the problems for us right now. So the House Democrats have put out their budget, and in their budget, they do have some of those proposals to help us moving forward, so we will have a sustainable budget moving forward. Next Tuesday is a cutoff for the fiscal committees, and we anticipate next Tuesday that the Senate will come out with their version of the budget, which is quite frankly going to be much different than what happened in the House. The House Democrats kind of did their budget on their own, and the House Republicans kind of did their budget, but in the Senate we've been working together since the day we came through the door, quite frankly, and we're anticipating putting out a budget next week that will be bipartisan, both Democrat and Republican involvement. Senator Zarelli and Senator Murray are meeting twice daily. Those are the two leading Republican and Democrats on the Ways and Means Committee, and they're spending a significant amount of time trying to get us to a point where we can change some of the policy, balance the budget, and move forward and make sure that our budget is sustainable moving forward. Oh, by the way, did I tell you? We have $4 billion more revenue this year than we had last year. So all the cuts you're hearing about, all the draconian things we have to do down here, we still have more revenue than we've had in the past. So, you know, it isn't exactly what everybody thinks. So looking forward to telling you next week about the Senate budget and where we're at, and thanks again for listening.